I think it's really, really important to listen to your gut, your own sense of your own mission, your own purpose in life. You'll get a lot of advice from people who say you can't do it, you'll never be famous, you'll never make money, all those things that really don't have anything to do with why people write. You get a lot of that. But I found that for me, listening to my own instincts and my own deepest feelings about things has always served me well as a writer, and that's really something that you really have to have, that ability. Teaching is essentially it's a people job. It's a job where you're really relating to people, inspiring people, helping people gain mastery over a particular subject. And I think that at its highest, teaching really is about transforming people, giving them a sense of what it's possible for them to do. So all of those things are of interest to me. And I find that in the classroom, I can use my God-given gifts very well. Poetry is great to study because in poetry, it's like every word counts. And poets work with imagery and images. And so they're working in a much tighter sort of framework. And so they sort of polish every word, polish every image. And so I think that's a good skill for prose writers to have. Well, I teach advanced nonfiction writing, which is a class that focuses on the personal essay. And we do a lot of memoir, autobiographical writing in that class. I also teach advanced fiction writing, which is a class that deals with advanced techniques in writing short stories, novels. And this semester I'm teaching African-American autobiography, which is a class that looks at the classic autobiographies. Writers write, they don't talk about writing. If there's research required, to do research, but a lot of it is just writing. You just have to set up a schedule. A regular schedule for writing. For example, waking up in the morning and taking a blank sheet of paper and just writing. Just free writing, whatever comes to your mind. Because I think it's important to demystify the idea of writing. People think that before you sit down to write, you have to know the beginning, the middle, the end. But that's not true. So I think it's important for people to just get in the habit of writing. It's not unusual, for example, for a beginning writer to write a short story. And in that short story are many elements that can be expanded into a novel. So a lot of times you just really don't know until you've done it. And if you start writing a novel and you run out 50 pages in, that's telling you you don't have a novel. I think it's important to listen to people. I think it's important to be empathetic. So that you look at other human beings and you care about them, you see yourself in their experiences. Sometimes we're just sort of looking around, but we're not really seeing. And we really have to practice seeing. We have to practice listening. And the ability to empathize with others means that even if you're just writing about people in your own neighborhood, you can imagine what their life would be like, how their life may be different from yours. You can really get into that experience. That a writer has to have the ability to get out of their own skin and to see and imagine something different.